Our first reading today is Psalm 111. Praise the Lord. I will extol the Lord with all my heart in the council of the upright and in the assembly. Great are the works of the Lord. They are pondered by all who delight in them. Glorious and majestic are his deeds, and his righteousness endures forever. He has caused his wonders to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and compassionate. He provides food to those who fear him. He remembers his covenant forever. He has shown his people the power of his works, giving them the lands of other nations. The works of his hands are faithful and just. All his precepts are trustworthy. They are established forever and ever, enacted in faithfulness and uprightness. He provided redemption for his people. He ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow his precepts have good understanding. To him belongs eternal praise. The next one is from Luke 17, 11 through 19. Now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, came back, praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, "Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well."
So just before learning about Ted and Willie a couple weeks ago, I went down to my parents' house at Castle Rock for a visit. Didn't stay too long, just a few hours. But it was time well spent. Don't do that enough these days. Life gets so busy. You know how it goes. We find ourselves constantly sliding to the side the things we find most important to our soul. We do it all the time, mostly for the same lame but pressing reasons. I gotta do this, then I gotta do this, then I gotta do this. And maybe if there's time, I can do that. And then we don't feel so bad about not opening ourselves to that experience of what matters. Because we've got this sort of phantom plan to see to it later. And of course, then that may be after the this and this and this is done, becomes no. Because we're too tired after all of that. And that cycle just starts all over again, right? But yeah, so I drove down to Castle Rock the other day. ride isn't short. And over the years, I ended up taking on this sort of long way around so that I could park the car at the corner before turning up the block. And that way, I could freshen up a little bit without being seen or stopped. And as I sat there in that afternoon light, shining yellow through the windshield, I thought about the presence of my dad. The scene sort of just stilled for a moment. And I realized that I was stopping there in that particular spot because I knew that when I pulled out to the driveway, my dad would be there, coming out to say hi before I even got out of the car. And I realized what a beautiful and wonderful thing that was. And I thought about the fact that though I was kind of avoiding him in that moment, that one day, I would give anything to see him come down the driveway and say hi to me and give me a hug. And that this was something to live into and appreciate each moment. It's still the truth for me now. In all of this, the thought came to mind that wouldn't it be nice if we could live each day like we were given a one-time pass to relive an old memory. How much more mindful would we be of the blessings surrounding us at all sides? How much more would we consciously cherish the beautiful gifts right here before our eyes? How much more would we pay attention to what makes us feel loved and alive? Instead of the this and this and this we think is so urgent to see to before. A moment of clarity in the clutter. And this is where our scripture readings lead us this morning. A moment in the Gospel of Luke from chapter 17, verses 11 through 19. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were there not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they?" Was none of them found to return and give praise to God? Except this foreigner. Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." So basically, Jesus is just walking along in this group of suffering people. 10 lepers in the story, right? Call out to him, begging for some rest. For healing. And without really announcing what he's doing, Jesus says, go on over to the religious leaders and let them see you. And on their way to walking over the priests, he heals every one of them. All 10. And it's kind of easy in these short words to dismiss what happened. And this ties in too. Because it doesn't go into fine detail about the profound things that happened in this healing. It doesn't talk about the fact that these people being leprous for who knows how long had walked around with this consuming ailment which caused them to be numb to the world around them. For medical look, this is the definition of the disease. Leprosy, also known as Hansen's disease, is a medical condition that attacks the surface nerves of an individual, causing a feeling of numbness and lack of sensation. Lepers lose feeling in their skin. And this is one of the reasons their skin becomes so mangled. Without that vital sense of the world around them, without a sense of touch, they tend to cut themselves and burn themselves and bruise themselves with ease. They get real beaten up over time. So yes, it's important to pay attention to the details of these stories that you read in the Gospels, particularly the Gospel of John, but also the Gospel of Luke and the other two. The ailment could have been anything, right? But in this story, it was leprosy affecting these 10 people. A lacking sense of the world around them. So this means that when they walked off toward the priests, their senses abruptly awoke. The numbness consuming them replaced and rejuvenated with feeling throughout. What before felt nothing, now sensing the touch of a breeze, the stroke of a hand, the warmth of the sun. Consumed now by a sense of life, filling every part of their person.